All right, hey, and welcome back to another edition of Code Review Guru. My name is Light, and I'm basically using this channel to document my process of obtaining the CSSLP and OSCP certifications. So I'm pretty much preparing right now to start testing on damn vulnerable web application. Last video, I installed OWASP Zap, which is a web application scanning tool. I'm about to also install and configure BurpSuite, just because you know they fill in the gaps for some things that the other is lacking. So I'm gonna do that. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. That's what this video is dedicated to, installing BurpSuite. There's a couple of steps with installing BurpSuite, which is why I gripe and moan about it. I actually uninstalled BurpSuite to do this video. So there might be some snags along the way because I haven't really dealt with BurpSuite outside of this before as often as I would have liked to, or at least in a very long time. So let's go ahead and download here. What you're going to do is go to this description. I'll send that to you. Well, I'll put it in. I'm going to go to this URL and I'm going to leave it in the description. There we go. So once you click download for your operating system, next thing you're going to do is save the file. I'm not going to save it again. And if you're running Ubuntu or Linux, the next thing you want to do is basically go to properties and then permissions. And just like Zap, you want to click allow executing file as program. And then you want to take another step, and that is go to the terminal, because what you just did there was give this the ability to run as an executable, but this has to now become an executable. I don't know what's the difference between that and Zap, because Zap seems to already come like that. But if you know, comment below. So you want to first CD into the directory that you're in there, that you have this file in. And then you want to run the following command to turn this into an executable, chmod x, and then you want to type in the file name. Wow, I want to spell burp like that. And then you're going to press enter. Cool. The next thing you're going to do is now run said file like we did with zap with .slash and then the file name. Might come across with an error, that's fine. Cool. All right, so far no snags. Now this is just the installer, so we're just gonna go ahead and leave everything with defaults and go ahead and extract this file. Taking forever. Maybe I should pause because I really don't want to stall. Phew. Like watching paint dry. Don't worry, guys. I plan on getting in. There we go. New computer soon. Next, we're going to press finish. All right, so once you did that, it should pop up to show you BurpSuite. Like I said, let's see if there's any snags, but you can clearly hear my computer is working hard. Man, it is old though, I'm not going to lie. So I think I might pause it here because it's taking. Okay, so I realized that it was me being slow. I now have, after running that installer, I now have a folder called BurpSuite Community, which I meant to say earlier that you need to install the community version because it's free. And once you do that, you double click here. Man, where'd it go? Oh, there it is. You double click here, and then you should see, voila. Now, I know that we're not just going to be using HTTP requests. We're going to be using possibly HTTPS requests. So HTTPS requests involve a certificate. You need a certificate of authority, a CA, to be able to have a, I won't say it's not secret conversation, but you to be able to to get the traffic, the HTTPS traffic. So in order to do that, we have to first configure BurpSuite's proxy as well as the proxy of our browser to then filter through or pass requests through to the Burp proxy, and be able from there to go to a site, Burp, and get the CA. I know it's a whole thing, but let's go ahead and start on our journey. So first we have to go to proxy, and I've already kind of, I guess it took my other configurations, but what I did here, I believe, was went to add, and then I typed in 8080, and make sure that your configurations are just like this. I don't know if I, if this is still from the previous or not, or if it was like this by default. But in any case, this is what I used to get this specific interface right here. So that's it for the BurpSuite proxy side. Remember, let me show you one more time. Enter 8080 right here, and then press OK. So the next thing I need to do is configure my browser. So I'm going to go here. I'm actually using Firefox. So if you're a Firefox fan, I'm here for you. What I'm going to do now is go to the preferences. I'm going to go down to network settings and then go to settings. And here, I'm going to click on manual proxy configuration. And I'm basically going to loop it back to come. This is how I'm going to get it to filter through to the Burp proxy. Basically, I'm going to put in my home address and have the port be 8080. I believe this is not checked, so you need to check. Or also use this proxy for FTP and FTP and HTTPS traffic. So once I do that, I'm going to press OK. And the next thing I'm going to do, everything is in check, in order. I'm going to have this checked. Yep. Cool. So the next thing I'm going to do is go to HTTP, and this is for me to get the certificate. Apparently, I think you need to go through Burp's proxy in order to get to this page. So I'm doing HTTP Burp, nothing else. Let me come over here, and then boom. So you click this button, which is a certificate, you press save, which I already have a copy, and that's pretty much it. Let me show you how this doesn't work if you don't do what I just did. So I'm gonna take off preferences, right? Instead of going through the proxy, I'm just gonna use my own, just gonna use the browser. Just not gonna set the proxy, and I'm going to press enter again. That's the page I get to. So make sure that you change your preferences to use the Burp proxy. Took me a while when I first learned this, for some odd reason. So anyway, you downloaded the certificate. So what you need to do now is go to preferences, privacy, and security, and go all the way down here to view certificates. If this isn't clicked, make sure this is clicked. And you're gonna get popped up into authorities. The next thing you do is click import, where you will then go to the file, I mean the directory, click on the file, open, save it there. Now, I think if I try to do it again, it would just give me an error. Yeah, it's already installed. So from there, you'll see all this, and you can see that, you know, it's actually already here. But from there, you just press OK. And that's pretty much it. Now we have installed BurpSuite as well as we've installed BurpSuite as well as configured it. So let's take this on a test run. How do we do that? Well, we go to preferences again. Well, let me go back. Alright, there we go. General is where I needed to go. And there's my dog again. Alright, so now I'm going to go to settings. Alright, we're still here. Cool. I'm going to turn on intercept. Oh, intercept is already on. Great. So I'm going to forward through. Now let's see about Google. Let's turn this off. Now let's turn it on. And let's go to Google. All right. See, it's holding on to that Google information right there. We have 443. Let's see. And I forwarded. Boom. Great. Now, if I take intercept off and say hello, I don't know, just throwing something random into Google. Oh, okay. A deal. But cool. So clearly it's worked. So I think we're ready for the next best thing now. So like I said, BurpSuite's installed and slightly configured, and OWASP Zap is installed and didn't need any configurations. The next thing I'm going to do is basically install Docker and then install the damn vulnerable web app from there. And then yay, we'll have some fun. But I'll see you next video.